Good evening and welcome to Central Seventh-day Adventist Church on St. Croix in the United States Virgin Islands. This is our Wednesday night prayer service and we hope you had a wonderful week so far and we thank you once again for joining us. I ask that you would join me in a short word of prayer before we begin. Dear kind and gracious Father, we thank you, O Lord, for the ability to be here both virtually, to see, O Lord, where your word can lead us this week. We ask that the words, the songs, the prayers, O Lord, all will be presented before you, and that your children will be blessed by it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Miracles when you move, it's such an easy thing for you to do. Your hand, it's moving right now. You were still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. But right now, I know you're able. Yes, my God will come through again. You can do no, you never lost a battle. And I know, you never win. Everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now. Whoa, yeah. Breaking up heart of stone, taking over like the Jericho. And our walls are all crashing down. But right now, I know you're able. Yes, my God will come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. You can do all things, oh yeah. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle.
Tonight, we're going to look at when God does some unexpected things. Have you ever been at the counter of your favorite fast food restaurant, ready to order what you want? You give the cashier your order in detail with specific instructions on just how you like it. An extra this, a side of that, and definitely hold the pickles. and you wait a long time for your meal, and you finally get it. And you get back to your vehicle, your home, just to find out that this is not what you ordered. But you're hungry and you decided to eat it anyway, only to realize that it actually tasted great and you would go back for more. Or do you remember a time when you were sick as a child and your parents gave you medicine that just tasted awful? But they insisted that it will make you feel better. But no matter how much you disliked the taste for the duration of your sickness, you had to take that medicine. But one day, you began to feel better. Your fever broke, your sinus cleared, your stomach stopped hurting, and you were finally free of the sickness that made life miserable. These two instances are examples that I'm sharing with you because prayers, desires, wants, and requests are often answered by God in ways we didn't expect or through situations we didn't want to experience. Tonight, there are two main points in the message for both you and I. Firstly, prayers can be answered in the opposite way of how you thought it should be. And secondly, desires can change your perceptions and opinions in life once you allow God to make that happen. So for our first point, receiving the opposite of what you prayed for. Let us look at the scripture for an example of this scenario. Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 5. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, that I will raise to David a branch of righteousness. A king shall reign and prosper and execute judgment and righteousness in the earth. Isaiah chapter 52, verses 13. Behold, my servant shall deal prudently. He shall be exalted and extolled and be very high. And lastly, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your midst, from your brethren. He you shall hear. The people of Israel, who for centuries had suffered at the hands of enemies and conquering nations, longed for the days when their Messiah and King would come to rescue them from all of their adversaries. They imagined that their Savior to be mighty and powerful, able to unite the people and form a strong nation that the world's kings and rulers would surrender to. But while under Roman occupation and rule, their Messiah appeared, but not as they expected. Their Savior, Jesus Christ, came in the form of a humble carpenter's son, a man of Galilee, who walked with the poor, the sick, and outcast of society. He did not come in royal fashion, nor did he command an army. He traveled as a commoner and proclaimed the righteousness of God, mercy towards others, forgiveness of one's enemies, and love for thy fellow man. What a stark contradiction in the eyes of those that sought for a political, worldly king to then see people proclaim that this man of humble origin was the Messiah sent to save Israel. Truthfully, God has sent the opposite of their expectations, but the perfect response to their long-held promise of a Savior. Israel at that time had become morally and spiritually corrupt as a nation. They had turned their hearts to stone and no longer resembled the people of God that were supposed to spread the glory of God around the world. But what does this mean for you and I? Sometimes our prayers are answered in ways that are not like what we wanted them to be. If we ask God to help us become a good person full of patience and wisdom, we may encounter individuals that stress us, that test us, and put that very same patience we are trying to build to the test. We may ask for wealth or health, but financial trouble and illness might afflict us. And in those trials, we realize that our wealth is not in our money, but is in our family, in our friends, and in our relationship with God. In those seasons of illness and physical weakness, we get to see the love of others that care for us. We see the way God can heal us and make us whole, that even though sickness may seek to destroy us, God can save us. Second point, God can use desires to change the way we look at life. Have you ever been completely confident that the way you see a situation is the honest and right way to understand it? That your convictions and perceptions are true and unwavering? The Bible speaks about someone that was zealous for God and his religious beliefs. After the crucifixion of Jesus, a man named Saul was certain that those following after the teachers of Jesus were a threat to the true worship of God, that their existence would harm the true believers of God and the traditional ways of the Jewish faith. He was committed to doing something to stop those that would spread the teachings of Jesus. And we see this in the Bible in Acts chapter 8, verses 1 to 3. At that time, a great persecution arose against the church, which was at Jerusalem, and they were all scattered throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. And the devout men carried Stephen to his burial and made great lamentation over him. As for Saul, he made havoc of the church, entering every house and dragging off men and women, committing them to prison. Continues in Acts chapter 9, verses 1 to 2. Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found anyone who were in the way, whether man or woman, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. From his understanding of religion and God, Saul was being a defender of his faith. His desire led him to take action against those that professed Jesus Christ as the Messiah and risen King. But one fateful encounter with Christ changed his understanding completely. Saul testifies of this dramatic change himself before rulers of the land. Acts chapter 26, verses 9 to 18. Indeed, I myself thought I must do many things contrary to the name of Jesus of Nazareth. This is Saul speaking. This I also did in Jerusalem, and many of the saints I shut up in prison, having received authority from the chief priests. And when they were put to death, I cast my vote against them. And I punished them often in every synagogue, and compelled them to blaspheme. And being exceedingly enraged against them, I persecuted them even to foreign cities. While thus occupied, as I journeyed to Damascus with authority and commission from the chief priests, at midday, O king, along the road I saw a light from heaven, brighter than the sun, shining around me and those who journeyed with me. And when we all had fallen to the ground, I heard a voice speaking to me, saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? It is hard for you to kick against the goads. So I said, Where are you, Lord? And he said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But rise and stand on your feet, for I have appeared to you for this purpose, to make you a minister and a witness both of the things which you have seen and of the things which I will yet reveal to you. I will deliver you from the Jewish people, as well as from the Gentiles, to whom I now send you, to open their eyes, in order to turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and an inheritance among those who are sanctified by faith in me. Saul continues to talk and says, Therefore have I obtained from God help. To this day I stand witnessing both to small and great, saying no other things than those which the prophets and Moses said would come, that the Christ would suffer, that he would be the first to rise from the dead, and would proclaim light to the Jewish people and to the Gentiles. This encounter was powerful. It changed Saul's entire world, and now he became a proclaimer of the gospel to all that would hear. God used Saul's desire to lead him to a different path. For us, we have goals, we have plans, achievements that we desire, plans that we have set in motion, spent time on, and even resources. But God can change them. That career that is not going where you want it to be right now might lead you to minister to people you would have otherwise passed by on the way up the corporate ladder. The plans to buy the house or fancy car, you might be interrupted by a sudden expense caused by an accident or family situation. But thank God the funds were there to handle the cost. The college degree that you have worked so hard for and taken out loans to pay might not be in line with the job that you currently have, but you do not know what God will put you through in order to place you where he needs you to be. Friends, I close and say, I have had my prayers answered in conflicting and amazing ways. And I believe if you stop and look at your life and the lives of those around you, you will see where God has done the same. I encourage you to be open to God's leading, to allow him to make changes in your life, to remove and add burdens, to open and close doors. He will always have your best interest and will lead you to a place of peace and joy in your life that you could never imagine. So thank you for joining us this evening. May God continue to amaze you as you continue to trust in him. Have a wonderful week and good night.